Today, I'm going to show you how to make advanced curved shapes using Tinkercad. So let's get cracking. Friends, this is a fun project. It was for Pickleball. A user in my Patreon asked how we'd make it in Tinkercad. ZDP189 shared the technique. Let me show you how to do it. Friends, we're going to get to the file with a bit.ly. It's bit.ly/pb for Pickleball and ZDP for ZDP189. Now, this takes you to the Pickleball demo. It was a question by Jason in my Patreon community. It has some real slick modeling skills. Of course, it is set to copy and tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad and give a reaction before you copy and tinker. We're going to also do a bonus trick. We are going to right-click and open ZDP's profile in a new tab. So now we can hit copy and tinker. You are immediately greeted by the awesome project. This is the STL that was imported. The user asked for how to make the shape in Tinkercad. If you look at this one, it cannot be ungrouped. STLs come in as a single piece. Now, this is the one that ZDP created, and you can ungroup it and learn all about it. Now, I'm going to quickly back up and take you to ZDP's profile because I want you to see all of his amazing projects, including this one right here. This is the full demo. Once again, set to copy and tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Give a reaction before you copy and tinker. Of course, once again, you've got ZDP's exact project and all the notes for how he solved it. You can, of course, check these out. I've got a strategy that's real similar. Let me show you how I'd do it. All right, so here we go with the steps. I'm going to get rid of the STL. I'm going to take this shape and do Control D to duplicate and set it back here. And then I want to cut this one exactly in half. We are going to make a profile. ZDP sketched his from scratch. We are going to cheat and I'm going to trace it from this shape. So to cut this in half, we need to take this measurement. I'm going to check it real quick. 76.6. So I'm going to do half of that, which is 38.3. Just going to type this in right here, 38.3, and press enter. And then we'll make sure it stretches behind it and above it. I'll grab the two of them, choose L for a line. Let's make that one the boss. And we just want to go to that edge, and we can hit center even though that doesn't really matter. Now when we select this and do Control G to group, it gives us the profile that we need for the awesome tool that we're going to use. I'm going to just flip this around to the angle that ZDP was using, just because it ended up pretty slick in his project. And let's grab a rotation handle and lay it down. Notice if you stay inside this circle, it's 22.5 degrees at a time. So four clicks, and then we can do D to drop. Like I said, we're going to trace this shape, and we're going to trace it with Sketch. For today's project, I'm going to just set this down willy-nilly. Then I'm going to hit Finish, and then I'm going to line this up with an edge. So see how this grid matches right there? And I can bring this one over and I'm going to match it to that same grid spot. We just want to make sure it's set up with the 20 by 20. Now I can double click the sketch to enter. And this makes it so much easier for tracing. We can start right here and go straight up. Don't worry about these under pieces, they're for later. And notice we can't get exactly to that spot. So I'm going to shut off my snap grid. Let's see if I can get there with 0.1, and I think that looks pretty fantastic. And then when you do one of these curves, we're going to switch from the line mode to the Bezier curve mode, and you want to go about halfway. Click and twist it gently to find something that's close. When you're happy, then you can click and continue. Notice it's not doing exactly what I want, so I'm just going to get close, and I'll adjust it later. Up here, I'm going to click, hold, and twist. And just continue that all the way around, trying to use as few points as possible. Don't forget, when you're done, you'll be able to edit it and get it more perfect. So now that I've connected it, let's go back and edit these points. We've got the options of corners. We can also have smooth handles, and we can have broken handles. Right here, I want to click on this, and I'm going to hit number 3 so that they become the dotted broken handles. That lets me grab this one independently. Notice if these dimensions are in your way, you can shut them off that easily. Now you can nudge, twist and adjust these until it looks exactly like you want. The more you practice at it, the better you'll get. Switching between the 2 and the 3 allows you to get them exact. I do want you to highlight that the more times you use the smooth ones, the more smooth your shape looks when it's finished. Once again, practice makes perfect. Just pop out, see if you like it, go back in and edit until you've got the shape exactly the way you want. I'm gonna grab this point and make sure I snap it down on the line so that way it's on the exact spot. Then I can click this line and hit the number 1 so that I'm sure that it's straight. And then we can click on this and make it look just the way we want. When you're completely happy, of course, hit finish sketch. Now, friends, we're going to use this shape with a tool called the SVG revolver. Real quickly, hit search and let's type SVG and press enter. When this comes out, you can set it down over here. And I just want to let you know the maximum sketch height is 20. This is something that we need to convert this to. So here's what we're going to do. We're simply going to take our shape, making sure that you made this edge flat. That was an important part. And we're going to shift shrink it down. And this number needs to be 20 and press enter. Now we're going to take that design and we're going to export it as an SVG. I'm just going to keep the name of the project and hit save. I'd already done it once, so I'm going to hit yes, and I'm simply going to replace the file. And now we can click over on our SVG. We're going to set the inside diameter to 0. We're going to max the sides. We're going to leave the rotation alone. That's why we've got it aimed like this. And we're going to choose that file we just created. Do make sure you're patient as you wait for it to arrive. We are also going to click on the revolve angle and we're going to make it 360 and press enter. You'll see the red lines as it thinks. And after a moment, there it is standing up. There it is almost finished. It'll take a couple times for it to actually click all the way through. If it doesn't for you, just remember you can always type the number again to get it to show up. Bang! We have just made the pickleball shape. It's just a little bit tiny and it has a hole in it. Let's plug that hole real quick with a simple cylinder. Bring that out and shift shrink it super small. I'm going to select them all, choose L for align, and we want to choose center and center. I got lucky and that lined up pretty darn amazing. I'm going to just leave it like that. Select the two and do Control G to group. Now we can shift scale to get it to the right size. And then we can simply use some holes to trim it so it matches the style we need. I chose to cheat and line mine up exactly with the one that ZDP had made. Of course, you could make these any dimensions you chose. And of course, simply hit Control G to group and cut our shape. And bang, you've got a custom shape that can be used to hold pickleballs. And of course, now you can make whatever custom connectors you want. Now, friends, of course, as I wrap up, I want to thank Jason for the question, ZDP for the help, and I want to challenge you, friends, to come up with other things we can use this skill for. You can add those as comments to the video, or you can even join the Patreon and add them in the group. Friends, of course, I want to say thanks to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget, there are 3 different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month, and with any level of support, you get early access to videos. I do also want to give a huge shout out to everybody that's part of the Patreon. Love how that group is growing. Of course, it has a free messaging area, which is absolutely fantastic. You can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.